Hello friends, welcome to my next video, Art of Presentation and Public Speaking. This is a really important topic, especially for the students and the teachers and those who are in the business field, and this will be really useful to you. Come, let's go to the video. If you learn this skill, it will take you to a long way in your life, because those who are good at public speaking will reap innumerable benefits. This video is an attempt to help you to get all those tips and to reach the greater level. And as well as, if you want to get more research related videos, please subscribe my YouTube channel and you will come to know a lot of videos, and there are so many playlists, you can check it up. And further, if you like this video, I'll be happy to hear your comments at the end. Find it useful, please, you can share to your friends. Very important thing, please watch this video from beginning to end to understand the entire ideas properly. How to speak, present so that audience will listen. This is the exact idea you will get at the end of this particular talk. This will help you to captivate your audience. The expected learning outcome of this particular video is you will learn tips on how to plan and write your speech for your presentation, and you will get to know the tips to deliver it effectively. Do you have glossophobia? What do you mean about that? Glossophobia means a fear of public speaking. Are you really worried? Are you really anxious about it? Don't worry. Because this will encourage you. 75% of people suffer from fear of public speaking. So it's perfectly normal to be anxious before a presentation. So nothing to panic, it's a perfectly normal thing. But after the end of this video, you will come to know how to come out of your, what you call, fear and anxiety. So if you want to give a presentation or a talk, always this is crucial to have a proper planning. Planning occupies a dominant role so that you can deliver the presentation or a speech in an effective way. If you do not plan, you are planning to fail. Let me repeat. If you fail to plan, you are ready to fail. So, very important thing, either in a presentation or a public speaking, you have to plan effectively. For that, what you need to do? You have to choose the topic, purpose of the speech and the presentation. When I deliver, today I'm talking about the presentation. So my purpose is to give you the tips and strategies to make you as an effective presenter. That is the purpose of my talk today. If I do not have the purpose, if I talk rubbish thing, and that nobody will listen to me. That's why the first thing, you need to know what is your purpose of the talk or the presentation. Be clear on it. Second thing, you need to customize the message. Whom I am talking to. See, now I'm giving this presentation, anybody will watch, not only students, business people, anybody will watch from my YouTube channel. So my content has to be in a such a way that it appeals to everybody. I have designed my presentation in such a way that it will be useful to anybody. Third important thing, you have to structure it, your presentation, the opening, the middle, and the end. What is opening? That's what I have opened with a kind of a statistics and certain information. I have told you that, do you have a glossophobia? Do not worry. Glossophobia means a fear of public speaking. 75% of people have that fear. I have started with that particular fact. Then it is kind of a grabbing the attention. That's what it's opening. Then I have introduced the topic. Then I'm getting into the, what do you call, I have talked about what is the expected outcome from my talk. That's also have given. So these are the things in the opening. It's very important. Then the middle, I'll be talking about all the tips. And the end, I'll be probably, what do you call, I'll be summarizing. That's what you have need to know, that OMC. That's OMG is a very known what do you call word, oh my God, you'll be using it in so many places, in a WhatsApp and a messaging. Here, just to keep in your mind, OMC, that is opening, middle, and closing. If you plan it effectively, then you are on a right track. What are the basics of planning? When you plan, there are three important pillars you should not forget. The first one, you have to keep these three things in. It's a kind of a triangle. The one is the audience, whom you are talking. Second one, what is the occasion? Is it any special function or any kind of celebration? Is it a very formal function or informal function? You need to know clearly. Because if it is informal, the way you need to talk, you should be something different. If it is formal, you are expected to talk informal. So you have to know what is the occasion you're talking. See, you are a wonderful speaker, but if you can crack jokes like anything. You have a great sense of humor. But if you overuse it in the formal occasion, it will become a very bad presentation. Nobody will like you because they don't have a time to listen to jokes. They came because they don't have time. You need to complete it on time so that they'll be having the next meeting. So there you cannot crack jokes. You have to be the point, be precise. Brevity is this, what it should be the base. The same time it's a celebration. You don't do it in a very brief because the people, they love to listen to you. That time you can crack jokes, you can do everything. So please be careful about what is the occasion. Third thing, the topic, the purpose of the speech, as I already told you that, please make sure that according to the purpose, you can add emotions to the talk. In case a farewell party, in case of opening office inaugural function or anything else, or probably you are giving an introduction to the chief guest, or you are giving a guest address. It depends upon the situation. You have to add emotions. Maybe you have to add a bit extra, or you have to reduce. So be clear about it. The purpose of the speech will tell you what kind of style you need to deliver. That's why if you understand these things, so you have to plan effectively, right? When you plan all these things, you need to know in case it is informal occasion, you are going to talk for 20 minutes, how do you need to start, what kind of humor you need to crack after 5 minutes, what kind of fact you need to give after 7 minutes. So you have to plan minute by minute. If you plan such a way, absolutely you can give a wonderful, effective presentation. And how to plan and writing the opening, middle and closing, as I already told you that OMC. Come, let's see, I'll tell you the tips. So when you want to give opening, first thing you need to know, the first 1 minute or 2 minutes is a very crucial time. The audience will decide whether they want to listen to you or not. So make sure that within 1 minute, you grab the attention of the audience. That's what, you do not have the second chance to make a first impression. First impression can be made only in the first choice. So create a better first impression, because if you create a better impression in the beginning, and the audience will be with you, they'll come along with you till the end of your presentation. In case if you fail in the first impression itself, then audience will just go away. Even you may give some good points in the middle, the audience will not listen to you because already they have decided that you are not a good speaker, you are not going to give a good presentation. That's why make sure that in the beginning, you grab the attention. Second thing, engage their interest. When you plan, always make sure that you are engaging them. What are the ways you can engage them? Probably suddenly you can ask the question, or you can pinpoint somebody and you can just interact with them, or you can say that just you can compliment there. That's a very nice shirt. Where did you buy it? So have some kind of informal chat in case if it is informal talk. If it is a formal talk, make sure that you are giving certain statistics or something else where the audience will be really engaged in it. Third thing, question. As I already told you that, you can ask a question. Probably it can be an open-ended question or a direct question. When you ask a direct question, please be careful, because if they don't know the answer, if they refuse to answer you, it will become really bad to open it. So make sure that always, but it is better to go with the open-ended question. So that, do you like this? Do you want to learn the techniques of the presentation? Please come to me. Please ask me one question. Where do you really feel difficulty in the presentation? In such a way, you can ask question. What is your presentation style? If you ask, you are pointing out one, a participant, you're asking, what is your presentation style? Then he has to think a lot and he has to answer you, but it's very difficult. So don't put the audience in the embarrassed situation. That's very important. So please keep them always comfortable so that they'll be with you. Otherwise, they'll simply go away from you. That means in mentally. And fourth important thing, you can start with a quotation also. That's what I have started in my presentation. If you learn this skill, it will take you to a long way. It's not a quotation, but again, it's kind of an anonymous quote. So you can start with such kind of thing. If you really good at the joke, as I already told you that, if you are really good at in the sense of humor, you can use it. Please make sure that whether it is a formal occasion or informal occasion. So in this five pattern, that is, you can keep it in your mind, G-E-Q-Q-J. That's the first two words, just you remember. Grab the attention, engage their interest, questioning or quotation or joke. And if you start with any one of these tools, absolutely you can grab the attention. Now you have completed, you have started well in the beginning. Then can you sustain it? Again, in the middle also very important, you need to sustain that geopolitical vibe throughout your presentation. So first thing, choose a few main points. So in the middle, you will be delivering the main content. So choose it effectively. Organize your main points in a such a way that you are giving them one by one with a lot of sufficient examples. And you need to present certain arguments also, why those points are important, why do they need to learn those things. And if you give it in such a way, because in general middle should be bit in what you call lengthy one, so you have to engage in a such a way that each point, then there is example, then another point, another example, anecdote or different things. So if you go in a structured way, probably the audience will not get bored. If you do not follow any structure, they do not know whether it is a main or not, what you call not important point. So be careful on that part. And in the closing thing, what you need to do? So first absolute thing, it's a very thumb rule. Always you need to summarize your main points. Because if you do not summarize, even in case if they have just deviated in one of the, sometime in the middle, because the attention span is very less, people may not, they'll not be, even though they are interested, they'll not be able to listen throughout the presentation. But when you summarize, probably even if they have missed certain points, if they have not understood certain things during your summary, it will be very useful for them to recall what they have learned from this particular talk or a presentation. And second thing, you need to stimulate further thinking beyond the speech. Don't leave with the just a summary of the point. You need to give us some kind of a stimulating point, some idea you need to give to them. For example, you are giving a presentation technique, and let me see you in another occasion as an effective presenter. So you are, when you close with this particular statement, you are indirectly asking them to be a wonderful presenter. You want to see them in the next occasion as an effective public presenter or maybe effective speaker. So when you leave with that kind of positive note, it will give a very, give a kind of a confidence on the audience. It will give the confidence to the audience. And always make sure that you are leaving with a positive impression so that they'll be able to linger with your ideas, whatever you have given in this, your talk. So they'll keep talking about it, they'll keep thinking about it, then you can really be happy that you have really created an impact. And during the planning stage and the writing stage, what are the other tips you need to follow? So as I already told you, that strong opening and closing, as I already told you, the humor, and what are the way you can have the humor? Probably even you can refer certain jokes, probably if you can use it in an effective way, you can use it. Sense of humor, probably you can, during the situation, you can improvise something and you can make humor, that's absolutely fine. Even if you do not have sense of humor, don't worry, there are so many things are available. Use just Google it or search it, just to make some humorous points and try to fuse it during the planning itself. Just you can plan with what kind of humor you need to use in that particular time, then that will really work well. In case if you are really doubtful about whether this will work or not, probably you can check with one or two of your friends to telling about that humor, and if they really like it, then you can go ahead. If they don't like it, you can leave it. Then another thing, personal story. See, always you can create a wonderful connection in the presentation and this public speaking when you tell about your personal story. But it is a very a tricky thing. If you give too much of personal story, they'll become really irritated. So you have to use it as a pickle. You cannot use it as a full meal. So you have to make sure that you are using your personal story only as a kind of a small value addition. But some of the people, they'll delve into the personal story, they'll forget the topic. So be careful about it. Personal story, you can to a certain extent without boring the audience, without overdoing, just to tell them, then they'll be really happy. In case I'm telling about the presentations, how I have improved my presentation skill. Because you don't believe me, to make this particular presentation, even whatever I'm using the PowerPoint presentation, it takes me minimum one day, one full day, 24 hours. Because initially I'll be taking the points, then I'll be rearranging the points, then I'll feed I'll make a presentation in a normal style, then add into the different transition effect and the other design and other stuff, then I'll change the fonts, then I'll rearrange because something I could have given in the beginning, then I'll change it. Then so it will take a long time. Even before start my video recording also, I'll do so many of things. You know, I'll be simply checking the lighting, whether the presentation runs properly. So these are the way you need to plan, because it's not a public speaking, even though I'm giving in a public platform. So I have to be clear. So the planning is very important. So how I plan, whatever the video, so how I have given so many, it doesn't come within a day. So it requires a lot of time thinking, planning, and then executing. Even you don't believe, certain videos generally it takes me even 2 to 3 days of preparation, and recording also it will take me maybe one day, because something I'll record it, then it will not work properly, then I'll re-delete it, I'll again go for the recording. It's a too much of thing you have to do. So in similarly, it is not easy task. You have to, if you work hard, at the end of the day, the output will be really good. Then you can go ahead with the quotations. Quotations are very simple. Simply just you search it and Google it. According to the situation, you can grab the quotation from the Google and you can make use of it. It's a very, very handy tool. Quotation is an effective tool, because you don't require to be sense of humor. You have to be very careful. But quotation, it's absolutely fine. Anybody can use it. The only thing is you have to select the apt quotations. Then last important thing, this is the area where most of them will fail. If you find somebody failed as a presenter or a public speaker, probably he will not have the empathy with the audience. What do you mean by empathy? It's not sympathy. Whenever you deliver a talk or when you give a presentation, you need to understand what the audience will expect. You empathize with them. Empathy means it's straight opposite to sympathy. You have to keep yourself into their shoes and you have to work on it. And if you understand their feel in their shoes, absolutely, you know what do they expect, how do they feel, and you'll be able to connect better way, you'll be able to understand them better way, and it will be absolutely a solid presentation. And after this planning, OMC, opening, middle and closing, then now it comes the delivery mode. You have planned your speech or a presentation. You have designed a PowerPoint, or just you have prepared a notes to talk oral presentation. See, at the end, even though you have planned well, the delivery mode decides whether it is really good or bad. If you deliver even a very a normal content, also can be delivered in an effective way. Your very effective content also delivered in a very normal way. So delivery plays very important role finally to decide whether a presentation is good or bad. So first thing, in case if it is a PowerPoint presentation, please do not read from the slides. You present it. I'm also using the PowerPoint now. I don't read exactly what is there in the slide. For example, delivery mode, reading from a script, less desirable, more difficulties your audience, reading rather than delivering. If you read like this, why should they listen to you? They can simply watch in the PowerPoint presentation. Again, you should not give all the valuable information in the PowerPoint. Then they'll not listen to you. You have to keep the important information with you. You should present. You should not project in the slide. Here, I have given only less desirable. What is less desirable? You do not know. More difficult to see your audience. Why? Reading rather than delivering what? So these are the only cues I have given. Less desirable here. Reading is less desirable. And when you read, you will never see your audience. It is more difficult to see your audience because you will be always concentrating on your PowerPoint or your what you call written script when you look at the audience. So when you deliver, you need to connect a proper eye contact. You need to have a proper eye contact. If you do not have eye contact, you will not be able to connect with the audience. So that is important. You need to look at them. You have to connect to them. You need to go to their personal space means without disturbing them. You need to have a such kind of very personal connection so that they'll be with you. And very important thing, when you deliver, make sure that you're using a proper pauses and falling and rising intonation. Do not go with the monotonous tone. If you look at my talk, the voice goes up and down. This is what, when your voice goes up, it is rising intonation. When it comes down, it is called falling intonation. Sometimes it's flat, it's what you call neutral. When it is important, please raise your voice. When it is unimportant, you can simply say that. So this kind of rise and fall will help the audience to be with you. Otherwise, if the monotonous tone will lead to the sleep, it leads to the what you call a boring, and people will not, even though they want to listen to you, they may not. That's why you have to be very careful about how you deliver it. And when you use notes, you have to use notes. See, is it necessary to memorize everything? No, absolutely not. Not necessary to memorize. You can refer the notes, but make sure that you have all your main points in the notes. Please refer them only occasionally. Do not every now and then keep referring your points, then it will not help you. Speak directly to the audience most of the time. That means I need to look at the audience. I need to talk to them. See, I am looking at the camera now. In case if I am looking at there, it is very important to get a presentation school. You have to maintain eye contact. But I am not maintaining the eye contact. How the people will listen to me? I'm talking about to maintaining the eye contact, but I'm not maintaining the eye contact. How will they with me? So you have to look at them straight away to the eyes. And if there are a large audience, make sure that you are looking at everyone. It's called what you call bird's eye view. You have to look at everyone and make sure that just you are looking at everyone at every time. And then and there probably you can ask them, there is a possibility you can ask them a question so that they'll understand that you are with them. And sometime reciting from memory, there are people very good at in memorizing the things. And can you deliver such kind of talk? Okay, it's perfectly normal. Oh, it's good. I have seen one student in my university. She gave a presentation, research presentation. She has presented almost 50 slides of presentation. To my surprise, she has not seen even a single slide content. Everything she has memorized, she has delivered it. But she has delivered it as if she is presenting. That's a very important thing. So when you memorize, it's a wonderful skill. You can do that, fine. But it should not look like you are just simply memorized, you are vomiting the point. You have to present in a such a way that you are talking from your heart. That's very, it comes from your heart. It doesn't mean that, if you simply memorize, it's a great presentation. No. If you are not good at memorizing, please don't take that strategy. Please go to the notes, but make sure that you are sparingly use the notes. So if you are comfortable speaking publicly completely memorized, it's well fine, but be careful not to repeat yourself. Sometime if you memorized, you may suddenly get confused which points you have delivered, which one you have not delivered. In case if you get such kind of confusion, better avoid memorizing, better go with a cue card or probably notes or the PowerPoint presentation with slides and anything. But very important thing, it should be in a such a way that you have to look at the point, what you call cue card as well as the audience. They should not know that you are looking at. What is the way? When you keep the cue card here, probably very down, you have to look down your seat. But when you keep it here, I can see the cue card as well as I can see the audience, so they'll not know that you are referring it. And even though you refer it, it doesn't look very awkward. So you have to be careful. These are the same strategy you have to use the notes. What are the delivery tips? As I already told you that a very important thing, a memorable entry. Memorable entry means how you have started your talk. Then presentable appearance. The speaker appearance also plays a vital role in some presentation. So you, according to the situation, as I already told you, it's a formal or informal, you go in the same way. In case for the informal occasion, maybe a party, and you are going in a, what you call, a blazer, it's absolutely fun. It will become a funny thing. So it is the official presentation about a conference. You're going in a very party wear. It's absolutely fun. So be careful according to the situation. Be in a presentable. And the very important thing, the power of presence, I would say the presence of mind. Sometime even though you planned very well, you rehearsed, you have taken everything, but sometime that may fail. So you need to know how to handle certain situations, certain unexpected thing in the using presence of mind. So if you want to be a good presenter or a public speaker, you need to have a presence of mind. Sometime what you have thought it would work very well, it may not work. Sometime what you had thought it would not work, it may work. So accordingly you try to fine tune and just get the cue from the audience, just go along so that your presentation will be really effective. And the speed and tone of your voice, as I already told you that, you need to vary your tone. It should go like this. Your tone should dance. But if the dance should not be in a flat, it should go up and down. And otherwise, if you are unable to dance with your tone, you cannot be an effective presenter. And eye contact, as I already told you clear. And avoid nervous gesture. Somebody will have always some kind of, they'll be doing some kind of thing. They'll be some kind of thing. Something what I'm doing, trying to do that. But when I keep doing like this, or some kind of breaking the hand, or maybe holding it, or just knuckling it. If you do like some kind of thing, the audience after some time they'll leave your content. They'll focus on your body language. So make sure that don't use any nervous gesture. Be very normal. If you ask me, I would say that please be ultra normal, be very, very quiet and comfortable, so that they should feel that you are just casually chatting with them. In such a way, you have to present it according to the situation. And whenever there is a necessity, please pass it. The pass will again the attention of the audience, because suddenly if you give a pass, everybody, even though they are chatting with their own friend, they'll stop it, they'll listen to you. So use that strategy also sparingly. So if you use all these things, and absolutely be able to give a effective presentation or public speaking. So be careful about planning, open OMC and N and delivery tips. And if you follow everything and one by one, and very important thing, you need to practice, rehearse it a lot of time. Then if you do all these things, absolutely you can deliver a stunning presentation. And if you want to check what you have learned from this video, please take all those things, just to plan your speech and prepare it. Use all the opening technique, middle technique and the closing technique, and record your talk based on the following topics. Maybe your favorite place you have visited, your role model or memorable incident. Please use whatever I have given in this video. Use all the cues about the starting and the middle, end, and what kind of a delivery tips, everything, delivery mode and eye contact. Check everything, and probably if you can deliver it with your friends, you can do it. Otherwise, just to record your talk with the camera in your mobile phone and check it up. Send to some of your friends, ask their feedback, and absolutely you can check it up whether it is really good or you need to improve. With this, you can do that. And these are the references I have used to make this video. If you like this video, please do not forget to subscribe my channel, and I'll meet you in the next video. Thank you. Bye-bye.